Hey, welcome back to the Girly Girl Bookworm. So today I have my last five reads for you. I've actually accidentally read six reads, but I'm going to save that sixth read for the next five reads wrap up because I can, so I'm going to. What ended up happening was I finished a book and then I was like, oh, I have time. I could read something else. And I ended up finishing it the same day and I was like, whoops, now that's six reads. So, and I didn't realize it. So I was like, whatever. I'll just include it in the next video. So I have five reads for you and I have one DNF for you. I've been on a DNFing roll lately, which is not necessarily a good thing, but a lot of DNFs lately. And that was The Astonishing Color of After by Emily XR Pan. This was super hyped up on YouTube for a very long time, and I got it as a book of the month, I believe the same month that it actually was released, if not the next month. So it was in March of 2018, so I either got it in March or I got it in April. And it's been sitting on my shelf, and it was on my, I was rewatching old videos, because I do that all the time, and I was watching my summer TBR video, and I was like, what books do I still have on my shelves that I have not read, that I haven't unhauled yet? What have I not read? This is one of them. So I was like, I'm going to give it a shot. Didn't really like it. I got about 124 pages in, and I was like, you know what? Stop torturing yourself. You're not enjoying it. Just put it down. This is about a girl whose mother commits suicide, and while her mother is committing suicide, she is getting her kiss from her crush, their first kiss, their first moment. So she kind of feels guilty about all that, and then she believes that her mother is now a bird, and she has family in, I want to say, Taiwan, and so she goes over to meet her mom's parents, and that's kind of where I've left off. It was okay. Not crazy about the writing style. It just kind of bounced back and forth between different perspectives, not perspectives, but time frames and ideas, and I this wasn't for me, unfortunately. Glad that everybody else loves it, but I believe that that's going to go in the unhaul pile. And also, in that video of books that I wanted to read last summer that I never got to was The Last Chance Matinee by Mariah Stewart. While I was reading this, my husband wanted to know if I was reading a book from Martha Stewart. This is the first book in the Hudson Sisters trilogy, I believe. As of right now, there's a third book that... There's three sisters, so my guess would be that it would be three books. The third book just recently came out. And this is book one. I got it off of Thrift Books. And I've just been wanting to read it, and I just kind of been putting it off for no real reason. I think it's because it's a meatier book. It's about 400 pages. And this read very slowly. This is about a set of girls, and there are two girls that are full-on sisters, and then there's this other girl, and they find out that their father has passed away, and they find out about each other. So they are actually all three sisters. The two sisters did not know about the one, and the one did not know about the other two. The father, unfortunately, had a kind of double life where he had one family in California and this other family on the eastern coast, and he has passed away. And he apparently chooses now is a really great time to introduce all of his daughters to each other, which, of course, rubs people the wrong way. They're all in various places of their lives right now. One girl is in the middle of getting a divorce from her husband. One other girl is already divorced and trying to deal with child situations of, who... custody, that's the word I was looking for, custody. And the other sister is living by herself right now, and she's kind of got a boyfriend. She's also rescuing animals and things like that. And they are told at the will reading ceremony that they have inherited this movie theater that unless they move in together, so they have a date that they have to move in by, and they have to fix this theater. If they don't fix this theater, or if somebody doesn't show up, or somebody leaves mid-project, guess what? They don't get their inheritance. So these three girls have to come together, they have to move to this middle-of-nowhere place, and revamp this movie theater, which obviously has lots of money that has to go into, and they only have $1 million to help restore it, and until then, if they run out of money, then they have to pay for it, so it's crazy. Each book is going to follow a different sister. Well, they all follow all of them, but for the most part, the love story connection Each book is going to have a different love story for a different sister. Overall, I enjoyed this. I gave it 4 stars. I just found it to be very slow, so I'm hoping that the next one picks up the pace just a little bit. I mean, for a trilogy and contemporary trilogy as it is, 400 pages is just a lot. So I still really enjoyed this. Gave it 4 stars. Already want book 2. I just need some distance between book 1 and book 2 since book 1 was kind of slow, but enjoyed this contemporary. Sorry, if you notice I'm like wiggling around my back for some reason. Well, not for some reason. I'm pregnant, but it's killing me right now, so I'm trying to get through this as quickly and as painless as possible. The next book that I read is The Night That the Lights Went Out by Karen White, and this follows a woman who is recently divorced. Her husband has moved on, and she kind of has to, like, leave everything behind, and she takes her and her daughter and son. Yes, her daughter and son. Sorry, I'm blanking. To this other town that she's going to end up renting a house from. And, of course, there's some buzz. There's a blog that starts by an anonymous person. And her life is kind of being thrown into this. And people are kind of judging her life. And these women are very different than the lifestyle she grew up from. And this alternates perspectives between her, and her name is Marilee, and Sugar. Sugar is a 95-year-old woman who definitely has a very different perspective on life because she has done it all and is very classic Southern, has those qualities and those expectations of what it means to be a Southern lady and all the stuff that is ensuing. There's lots of secrets. There's lots of drama. We're trying to figure out her secrets, and we're trying to figure out Sugar's secrets, and we're trying to figure out Marilee's secrets. And there's a little bit of a thriller aspect, I guess you can say, in it. Not a huge one. Again, this is another book that started off pretty slowly, but by the end I was definitely gripped and wanted to know more. So this was another 4-star read for me. I did enjoy reading this. And I'm really glad that I have another book by her that I can give another shot to, and I'm hoping that that one will read a little bit quicker. I feel like I wanted to say something else, but now I don't remember. But I think that it is definitely a read that is worth checking out. Whew. I'm starting to, like, get winded and tongue-tied. Sorry about that, guys. The next book that I read was For Better and Worse by Margot Hunt. And this book is a book of the month book that I have had sitting on my shelf since I believe I got it in like November. And I've been wanting to, and I've been seeing a little bit of hype, and I've been avoiding all reviews on this. Anytime somebody starts reviewing, I skip over it. This follows a couple, and they have been married for a while. They have a son who is 11. And they find out that the principal of their school has unfortunately been having some relations with some children. And they end up finding out that the principal had some inappropriate relations with their son. And the mom is actually a lawyer, a defense lawyer. And she normally, like, obviously normally goes the route of, like, the police, get the police involved and things like that. But she doesn't want to put her son through a trial like that. So her plan is that she wants to murder him instead. Because on their very first date, the husband and her were talking about how they can get away with murder. And she was like, remember that one time when we had that conversation about how we could totally get away with murder? And he's like, yeah. And she's like, well, let's do it. And he's like, no. So the husband really doesn't want to go along with it. Obviously, things ensue. I found it a very, like, compared to the last two reads, this was a book that definitely read really quickly. The writing style was very simple and easy to get through. The only thing I have to say is I wanted more twists. I wanted more turns. I felt like this was very well done, but by the end, I just wanted more from it. I wasn't satisfied with the ending. I felt like there needed to be some, I don't know, I just felt like there needed to be more drama and something more intense to end this. So unfortunately, I did not love it as everybody else does. I gave it 4 stars, so I still really enjoyed it. I just wanted a different ending. I wanted something more intense. After that, I was still going with the quick route because it was the end of May, and I was like, I need to get one more book in. And I ended up picking up Hello Sunshine by Laura Dave because it was short. And this is a contemporary novel, and this is my third book that I've read by her. And I have to say, I really like this author's writing style. Again, she makes it really easy to read and really nice to get through. This girl is living the dream. She is famous on YouTube for being a chef, and she's about to get a Food Network deal, and all of a sudden, she wakes up on her birthday, and there's these tweets that are coming out that are just trashing her and dropping all of her secrets, and it's just upending her life. She loses her job, she loses her house, and she loses her husband all in one night. She has to go back to her family's house, where she really hasn't talked to her sister in about 9 years, and her niece is there, and she's trying to find herself with family. She, like I said, lost her husband, so she kind of was trying to figure out, like, do I get my husband back? What do? How do I get my life back together? And I found this to be really, really good. I either gave it 4 or 5 stars. I can't recall. I don't know if I gave it 5 stars or not. But overall, if you are looking for a light contemporary, Laura Dave's are usually really fun. This book, the author's craft of the character sounding like she's talking to you, and explaining her life to you, that I found really intriguing, and I recommend this book as well. And the last book that I have to share with you is my first book that I read in June, and this is going to be for my Golden Girls Readathon, which I am currently vlogging. I plan on doing, like, weekly vlogs up until I finish either all the challenges or if I just want to do the whole month. I haven't really decided yet. But the first book is About a Girl by Lindsay Kelk. This is to cover reading a book with gold on the cover. I felt like the highlight of the past 5 reads is slow. This book was really slow. The very beginning, I kept falling asleep, and I was like, I bet you, like, this is probably just my mindset, like, it's just me, not the book. But then I would pick it up at a different time and I was falling asleep, and I'd pick it up and I'd be falling asleep. It took over halfway for me to not be doing that. And it's hard because everybody recommends Lindsay Kelk. They say how amazing she is, and I didn't see it. I didn't love it. This follows a girl who, out of nowhere, gets fired, and she has to really figure out her life. She's living with a roommate that she despises. She's been in love with her best friend, Charlie, since, like, they met, so she's been, like, in love with him for 10 years. She's got a quirky best friend named Amy, and she's really trying to piece her life back together. And I have a really hard time because the back reveals something that is obviously crucial to the plot, but it doesn't happen until page 100. So I get kind of torn with, like, do I tell you, do I not tell you? Because this book is 400 pages, so is it really spoiling that much? I don't know. All I'll say is she ends up in Hawaii for a certain reason, and she's trying to find herself, trying to figure out love, figuring out where she's going to go when she comes back home to England, and really a journey of self-discovery. I gave this book 3 stars. Like I said, it was really slow. I find this main character to be kind of annoying. I just felt like she was too wishy-washy, and she was making some really weird decisions, and she was very, like, woe is me. For a 400-page contemporary novel that's a series, this is the first book in a trilogy, and the rest of the trilogy follows her, so it's not even companion novels. Like, we will get 2 more full-length novels of her. I just found it to be very whiny and very dragged out, knowing that there's still more to this story. Like, unfortunately, I gave this book 3 stars. I still want book 2 because I feel like because it's not companion novels, I don't have all the answers, and I want all the answers. So I feel like I will continue with the series. It just didn't wow me like everybody else felt when they read this, or when they've read other books by this author. Wasn't crazy about it. So those are the last 5 reads that I've read. I'm not going to tell you what I'm currently reading because it's in my vlog, and I'm not going to tell you that 6th book. So you just have to wait and find out. So I hope that you guys enjoyed this video. I hope to see you really soon. We've got about 7 more school days left. Well, I guess now today's over, so I guess I count it as tomorrow already. So, like, 6 more days of school. We're done with kiddos the 14th. But unfortunately, I'm not done until the 21st because of professional development days, and I signed on to do curriculum hours. So we're very close to summer. I could taste it. Just not quite here yet. So I'm hoping that I will be around a lot more once that happens. But I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I will see you guys really soon. Bye, everybody.